important might happen today. I'm going to announce who's going to start in the game at quarterback. Grayson Lambert's going to start the game. And there may be other or others get in the game, but right now the thing that I know is he'll start the game. And very, very close competition. It's still being contested in my mind. But at this point, we felt it'd be wise to name a starter and get him ready to play in this ball game to get the number one with the reps with the number one units. Fatone and Bryce will take all the reps with the twos, and we'll start playing ball that way and see how it goes. And this will be the last question. No. I do have an event I need to be at here tonight, so I won't be able to stick around too long. But matter of fact, I wasn't even going to come in, but I thought you guys might want to know this. So,
Coach, what in particular stood out to you with Lambert's abilities and to make you want to go ahead and take this?
It just was a cumulative grade, so to speak, or cumulative performance. You know, all this time, y'all probably thought I was being real coy about it, but I really didn't know, and it was very, very close. Even on this decision, very, very close decision to name him the starter. But I think they all can get us in the right plays. I think they all can get us the right protections. I think they all can function extremely well and help us win. That's what made it really tough. I can't tell you how many times we went back and forth on the thing, quite frankly. So it was very close, but Coach Schottenheimer and I decided it would be wise to decide on who it is now so we could kind of get it over with, so to speak, and maybe within a day or two everybody can settle down and just play football and think about winning. he'll start the game.
I know that you have to, you know, base it mainly on what you've seen over the last month, but obviously this is a guy that had a track record in Virginia, some good games, some bad games. How did that figure?
Had no bearing whatsoever. Anything that happened at Virginia had nothing to do with the decision for him to start. It might have had something to do with the decision to have him come on our campus, because that's what we had to go by, you know. We didn't invite him blindly. You know, we watched his film and felt like he could function and do the things that we're going to ask a quarterback to do here at Georgia. But we didn't say he's going to come in and be our starter by any means. We told him he would compete for that job and legitimately have a shot to compete for that job. And, you know, and to this point, again, he'll start in the first game.
Will you have a plan to get someone else in the first half?
We're definitely... we're very interested in doing that. I'm not going to make any promises right now, but we'd like to be able to do that.
Coach, how did you deliver the news? I mean, what was the process on
Coach Schottenheimer just let them all know today. Called them in before practice and talked to them.
Coach, how much did the fact that Grayson, as you stated earlier, it's like been in the fire and been facing playing to your decision?
Again, anything that he did at Virginia had no bearing on the decision to name him the starter today. But it did have something to do, you know, again, watching him helped us decide to bring him in. So what we saw in Virginia, we saw enough to bring him in and tell him he had a legitimate shot to compete for the job. But what happened to Virginia had nothing to do with this decision today.
When did you and Coach Schottenheimer finalize this decision?
We were pretty sure Saturday, but then this morning we talked about it one last time. We said we'd sleep on it and think about it some more and decide what to do. So that's what we did. We'll get one more and I'm going to go.
Has this been the toughest decision you had to make on one of them since your time here as head coach?
It has been. It really has been, because it is such a, you know, it's a big deal. It's a big position. It's one that you normally don't roll guys in and out all the time and don't think twice about it. Just about every other position on the field, you can do that. The quarterback, people tend not to do that. you know, for good reason. But it's a tough decision because they're all extremely hard workers. They're all smart. They're all capable. They're all talented. And it was just a battle that didn't define itself. And I say no one really pulled away. And I can still say, I can't sit here and say Grayson just pulled away from the pack. They were all doing well, in our opinion, but he got the nod. All right, gang.
Thank you, Mark.